That's the Bowery duo, Keenan Jones on soprano saxophone, and Chaser Holmes on the drums. Let's give it up for these guys one more time, please. Welcome to Bowery Poetry. This is Poet in New York. These gentlemen are going to be backing up all you poets that come out here tonight. How many of you guys have been to Bowery Poetry before? Well, come on, let's shout it out. I want to see. What about total newbies? People who've never been here before. Oh, whoa, 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 whoa. We got a lot of new people tonight. Where are you guys? Where are you coming from, man? You got the two hands up. Bronx? Why haven't you? Where have you been all my life? Okay, fair. Good answer. What about you guys? Where are you from? All right, New Jersey, a little further. Well, not much further away. Come on. Any out-of-countryers? Oh, wow. We got a lot. Where are you guys visiting from? England, London, Germany. Are you traveling with them, or you just got stuck at the table with all the Britishers? It's fine. If you need a break, just let me know. We'll find another table for you. Are you guys all poets? What brings you to the States, all of you Britishers? You're studying English? So you came to America? That's an interesting choice, right? Huh. Okay, well, we're going to do our best to provide you with some current literature. I missed you guys. I was gone last week. And it gets a little dim in the head, I would say, when you're not continually refreshed with art, with new art. And I was on the beach, I'll be honest. I got a little tan. It was really nice. But still, there's the sound of the waves, and the sound of the waves gets a little monotonous, I gotta say, after about a time. But the sound of you guys never gets monotonous because it is so varied. That's something that I always love about open mics. It is so varied. You never know what style of poetry you're gonna get. You never know what quality of poetry you're gonna get either, which is something that's kind of interesting too. Good poetry, bad poetry. I don't know the difference. Maybe you guys do. Maybe you like something more than another thing. That doesn't make it better or worse. It just means you particularly like it. And there's very few things like that, which is why I love it. So welcome to Poet New York. How's everybody doing? Yes. I love this guy. The Bronx is fantastic. Everybody else is just doing okay. But the Bronx is the place to be, except Monday nights when you're at Bowery Poetry. So I gotta say, we got Frances over there at the bar. She's going to keep you happy as long as she's well-tipped. That's an important element to this. Can we get a little music kicked up? So get a sense of what's happening here. So you are going to start reading your poem tonight. And then these guys are going to get a sense of the tone, the vibe, the feel of what's happening. And they're going to pick up a little riff behind you to create that wonderful backdrop to your poem. We have some incredible features tonight. We have Urayoán Noel in the house. Can you give him a big round of applause? We also have Marcelo Hernandez Castillo in the house. It's a very special feature for you all tonight. And we've got, y'all, how many of you guys signed up to read a poem on the open mic? That's what I thought. We got some shy people in the house. We've actually never had this. This is our 110th show. 110th show of Poet New York, and we have fewer than 10 signed up to read on the open mic. I just gotta say, you guys are all shy tonight. I don't know what it is about April 1st coming up or something like that. Maybe people are getting a little nervous about being fooled or something like that. I don't know what's happening. All I'm saying is, you students from the UK, I want to hear something from one of you. So, or two of you. So you got to pick your representatives, or maybe our German friend will pick which of you she wants to read, and you guys are all going to get up for us and do it. So, one more. Oh, we got a list ready. Thank you so much, Shannon. Shannon is going to be photographing this, live Instagramming it. We are at PoetNY on Instagram, so if you want to follow along, or if you perform and you want to see yourself, that whole thing, at PoetNY on Instagram. All right, without further ado, let's get things started. I would like to welcome to the stage Hobart. Where are you, Hobart? Oh. It's who I wanted to start. Hobart, come on up. Oh my God, there's even no way to get on stage. It's so, ooh, he's coming. It's happening. All right, let's give him one more round of applause. Hobart!
Lucky me, first up. You can probably tell from my accent that I'm from Queens. Sydney, all right. Okay, paper. I bet no one else has got paper. You've got phones, haven't you? Yeah. After leaving the sea, I tried to remember what it was like to be afloat. But I could no longer imagine that I'd ever been so buoyant. I sank inside. Without the water surrounding me, it's impossibly hard to float. To feel elated and hydrated. To feel like a boat has never been overrated. So in my mind would not imagine me adrift. Surely we should be able to carry such a fabled ability wherever we go. I try again, concentrating this time on the times I'd swum with ease. Such a natural when wet, such a wag when he's splashed, no longer dry and crusty. Did you know, in fact, in me, 98% is water? Another fact, in fact, is that liquid water is hard to find. In a solar system, it's the Goldilocks spot. So rare in galactic terms, really light years between drinks, my friends. Yes, in Lawrence of Arabia, Anthony Quinn yelled, "I am a river to my people." Playful otters smashing shellfish to death on their stomachs and rocks in the sea. Killer whales with dead seals, tidal waves and tsunamis. The water keeps coming at me. It comes and it pains. With a particular sound like a gurgling down the drain, heard by those about to drown. And so I sank inside. Mentally, I rang myself out and try again, knowing that dense water is denser than I and I should float. But for reasons unknown, I am denser than rock and denser than iron and obviously fucking Jacques Cousteau. I see a cork and it feels good to look at cork, you know. When it's heavy on your being, seeing a cork is so freeing. Let's face it, these feelings are free. And feelings, sorry, light kind of thing here. That's the phone. Anyway. Feelings are like cork. You have to just feel them. They bob and dive and float until they just drift away. Feelings are different to emotions. Emotions are full of story, full of woe or glory, like a hero lost at sea. I return to the shoreline and wait for the tide to come in and swamp the land. The emotion I felt at my failure to float is now just a little damp. I feel it's just a little feeling, like a tightness in my chest. Just a feeling I'm feeling discreetly, and then without trying, it vanishes completely. A crab looks up at me and wonders if I'm up for eating it. It doesn't move, so neither do I. If I move, it will assume I'm hungry and run away. If I stay still, it was like I was never there. In a mock guru voice, I hear myself say, I have become the floating, and the crab has become my thinking. Pretty fucking deep ending, hey? Yeah.
Not only was it deep, but thank you very much. Can we have one more round of applause for Hobart, please? Yes. I had that terrifying experience this last week. It's so bizarre. No, you're at a pool. Yeah, I bonded with you even before that I knew you, but it so often happens with poetry. I was there, I went to the pool, you know, I had my cocktail, I had my poetry book, I was all ready, put everything down, got in the pool, went to lay back. You know, as you do, you stretch your arms out, and you look up at the sky, and you expect to just float, and then it just started sinking. The same experience you had. I mean, I thought it was because my soul had died or something like that. And you gave me some other ideas. So I don't know if I feel better about the experience now, but I think I have another way of considering it. Maybe I just need... It's a metaphor. Shit. I hate when I misinterpret poems. I take things very literally, which is why I run a poetry club. Let's see, who the hell is going to be next to pull us out of the depths of the ocean? Yeah, but it's not so bad to sink, I guess. That's why you get those floaty things. They're comfortable. I'd like to welcome to the stage, please, Mr. Mike Lyles. Let's welcome Mike to the stage.
How's everybody doing? We good? Yeah. Cool. Yeah. You hear me good? Hear me well? Yeah. All right, let's do this. I move into crowds, feeding off attention like a mosquito, seeking companionship with a blood rage, soaking up everything, becoming addicted to a willing ear, ready to accept the polished me. With every retired day, the hunt begins. This beast has been in pursuit for years, fearing self-judgment. This crippling pain that's been keeping me from honest correction. I'm running into groups seeking self-correction from an audience. There are not enough people in the world to feed this need to please crowds. Being trapped within the quiet mind triggers a feeding frenzy. Anxiety, an anxious mind, is like a five-alarm blaze. So let this hunt begin. I spy my next victims, quenching this thirst. I will suck all this attention from every crowd that I see. This is all I know. Hopefully it can work this time.
Do we have any people in the house who consider themselves improvisers? Yeah. Yeah? Oh, we got one right here. Yeah, so, or hosts, or MCs, or performers, or any sort. Yeah? Oh, God. I gotta find a question that you do not answer yes to. I'm thinking of one. You walk up on stage and your mind's totally blank, and then you expect by the time you get to the mic, something's gonna come out. You hope it does. Sometimes it doesn't. It always used to for me, and then I was driving back from a road trip, and I was trying to unpack the car, and I opened up the trunk, I guess that's what it's called, and I slammed my head. And ever since then, I just walk up on stage, my mind's just blank. It's such a nice kind of ignorant bliss. I just kind of say the anxiety of performance is gone, but so is any of the thought behind it. I just sort of stand up here and look at you guys and just feel chilled out and start floating, sinking, dropping. I gotta get crabs, right? I need crabs. If I get crabs, then I'll have thought and I'll be okay. I was focused on the crab element, but I'll get back to the cork element. And we need more wine to get to the cork element. Is anyone drinking wine? Yeah? Which color? Nice. That's nice that there's, well, rosé. I'll make some of that later by mixing the two. Cheap man's rosé. All right, I'd like to welcome to stage Nick. Where are you at, Nick? Come on up, Nick! Uh-oh, I think you might have brought some of these. Woo!
Hello. I'm guessing people will be able to understand with the accent. So I typed a poem and I was going to read it. And then I thought I'd go to MoMA and walk around and make a poem up on the spot and then read that instead. So let's see how that goes. That, I think that was banter. Right, anyway, right, okay. Dear Frank, you don't know me, but, I mean, you don't know anything about me. I mean, have you seen the Museum of Modern Art lately? I mean, just look at that guy. He's got a GoPro on his wrist while he's eating. I mean, his wrist is bigger than his belly. I mean, it's disgusting. I mean, every picture frame and pedestal in MoMA has been fitted with a big red heart-shaped button. I mean, big and red, like a big red cabbage. I mean, you press the button if you like the art. I mean, if you feel you like it. If you feel like feeling something, anything. I mean, each time anyone presses any one of those big red plastic hearts, a number gets bigger on a big red crawling LED marquee. I mean, it stretches right the way around the sculpture garden like a crappy 90s website in mosaic. I mean, you never had to go through anything like that, like dial-up or bowel cancer, which, I mean, is objectively worse, obviously. I mean, there's got to be some benefits from getting run over. I mean, getting run over by some idiot bro out to impress his date with a Twilight joyride on a boosted beach buggy. I mean, I bet you wish she hadn't swiped right on his profile pic. I mean, whatever the equivalent in 1966 would have been. I mean, people are still idiots. I mean, you can Snapchat yourself eating katsu curry, and that's a thing. Like making duck faces in front of the Jackson Pollocks. I mean, yes, I'm cultivating a Dom DeLuise shtick, thank you for asking. I mean, it's a work in progress. I mean, my heart is a black book. I mean, a prancing pony and a small red saddle and the small red heart that sits there. Dear Frank.
I like following the thought at the end. You're like, oh, my heart's like a black book. And then you, how did you get to the pony after that? Those are very different things there. You just feel like, oh, it's a little bit small to be a closed black book. We're going to be a prancing pony, but a little one with a little red saddle. Where did that happen? All of that. Perfect. The other thing that I noticed about you is that you rolled your sleeves up, which I forgot to do before the show. Which is a great thing to do, because then you're ready. You know, when your sleeves are all the way down, you're not ready for anything. You just get your sleeves rolled down, but as soon as you put them up around your elbows, and you could do anything. You can put your elbows on the table, and it looks like you're ready to arm wrestle or something. Which is like what an open mic is, an arm wrestling with yourself. I'd like to welcome to the stage, please, Elizabeth. A famous arm wrestler of the self. Woo! Ow! I'm
gonna sit down.
Oh, yes. Absolutely.
Okay, the name of this one is Electric Love by me, Elizabeth. So, has nothing to do with love, though. All right, looking in my mirror, I see Obama's pastor. Everywhere I go, I'm an unpaid actor. The overhyped mainstream long to be my master. Folks are undersized chokers, and it's difficult to breathe. They like to tell me just how they feel about me. You should visit a salon, get dreads, or even a perm. The back don't look good. When you gonna learn? Your hair is unkempt and looks super crappy. You say you like Pharrell, so smile and act happy. You'd probably have a job if you tried a little harder. If homeless Will Smith could do it, you could do it too. I heard Chanel would love to hire someone like you. You complain about money, yet your closet is a parlor. And yeah, I've been holding out. There's something y'all should know. My mom's a plastic surgeon and my dad's a CEO. I mean, I'd probably move back to Baldwin Hills if it wasn't for the poverty. I know I asked your opinion, but your blunt facts really bother me. Liz's words are sharper than the dagger that ended McQueen. You're the type of person that can make Dr. Martin Luther King not want to dream. This black rich girl stay bitching when his life is super easy. You always say you hungry, yet you stay eating. I asked how you get bread, because you said you stay scheming. Where you get your money and clothes from, if it ain't your mom and dad. Must be that trust fund. If I was you, I'd be glad. And she never reps Africa. Look at her with American clothes. 125th is having a sale. Even your professors know you like those. Why don't you go and get a dashiki and a kufi from down the road? And if you didn't have hair, I wouldn't believe you're a trini. I'll just wait on the blood test. I took swabs when you were sleeping. Now we'll see if it's the actual truth that you say you've been speaking. Which one are you anyways, a gay woman or a straight man? And if you were born a woman, why are you trying to be like Shiloh? I don't really like liars, so why don't you tell the truth? If you wore heels and makeup, you'd probably look cute. Like a worm, you are a true catch. Don't worry, you're every disrespectful and broken man's dreams. Start little, try being a princess instead of a queen. And what's good with you anyways? Why the brothers ain't enough? Always talking about white men, and we all have had enough. Just because you're too dark for me and Rodman don't mean you're too dark for them. And white man can't jump or smash. What could you possibly do with Bob? She stayed trying to be white, always putting them on a pedestal. And when you're going to get a man anyways, your ovarian clock is ticking. But you can't do none of that if your red box is missing. Summer in Calabasas with a mink couldn't make you hot. You better not think you popping, because girl, you know you're not. And if you like kids, why don't you want any? You'd make a great grandfather one day. Suspenders and ties with hair that's white and gray. Listening to routines talk back all day. Why don't you board the Lusitania and be just like us? You already know in Facebook and Twitter we trust. It's impossible to spend the day on eBay and Wikipedia. We don't know how you could live life without social media. And reading Thomas Hobbes will have you sounding like Charles Bukowski. Lord knows I don't need any realists around me. And you scare me when you say that you hate people. You were born a homo sapien, so tell me what's the reason. I'm not going to listen anyway, and everything's going to get misconstrued. But you're still my friend, even when you ask me for my food. Being Sir Richard Branson will just get you nowhere. You look so aloof in your island over there. And you say that you're an introvert. That means you don't like good company. You didn't crack a smile, even when my jokes were unfunny. And worst of all, everyone thinking I'm the baby. You can hit me up when you graduate high school, maybe. We're just trying to help you. That's why we're telling you the truth. We wish people told us this when we were in our youth. And what's really good with your music taste is just plain trash. Sundays in Williamsburg have never been the qualifications for a hipster. What's with this Vampire Weekend and other stuff that'll never get airplay? You must be crazy, and I ain't talking about Ken Rebel. You still listen to Dipset. What is this, 1400 BC? And what you know about Kane, you never seen a rock. Like a fish out of water, all your artists do is flop. Listening to that marshmallow-ass rock, indie's been dead, and so are all the other genres. Rub a million sticks together, and kid rappers would never even spark. They would never be noticed, even if they glowed in the dark. Lil Ryan could drop his mixtape in hell, and he'd never be fire. But since I like you a lot, give him this lighter. Mainstream 95 said to light the candles in his room and then knock them down. It's better this way, since Def Jam will never like his sound. Your artists are just whales in the beachside. Listen to the radio next time you go for a drive. And everyone's so enlightened with rationale similar to this. You're mixing Obama up with Saddam. His middle name can't be Hussein. He ain't a Muslim. He don't be flying them planes. My head held high as I accept a broken W, thinking in my head, son, what is really up with you? Charlemagne the God told me the aforementioned are just donkeys of the day. I feel like a star, too. We both belong on World Star and Fox 5 News. I wish I came twice when the world sucked the skin off my scrotum. But it feels more like molestation than Jaden's electric love. I used to pray for God to bless America, but where and who is God in this godless America? And they all tell me that happiness is not far away, so I keep pushing that boulder up the hill, hoping to see it yesterday. That's it.
Please give it up one more time for Elizabeth. Woo. Yeah, anybody is welcome to sit down on the stage, but only Elizabeth can pull it off. So you guys are welcome to try. I'd like to welcome to the stage, please, Kayla Martin. Come on up, Kayla.
On line number 2, the in-between length, everything is so swollen, I can't really talk. We are forced into these interactions with others to reduce the possibility of having a tear. There was liquid damage, and it's listed right here, for disassociation. There is something about the mark of an X that is flawed. Every time I hear this song, it's as if I am on a plane. It wasn't even two words, and we are on the same plane. Pulling the phone away from you, it blows the words that fall out the end. Can I have one with handles to carry? For delivery, please. The body full of hell, Rose. Can I get a ride? Can I ride with you? Can I get a ride with you? Can I get a ride with you, baby? And the expiration date is, thank you for your time. The mist that is missed.
Can we please have one more round of applause for Kayla? I was around here the other night, and there's a group of guys leaving, and someone was like, yo, let me get a ride with you. And the guy was like, well, I'm going to actually take an Uber. He was like, well, can I get a ride in your Uber? Uber? Ubu? How do you say it? Uber? Uber. I have a friend who calls it Uber, which I kind of like. Uber. And he's like, well, you could Uber split it with me or Uber pool it with me or something like that. What is that when you can, like, both pay for a ride? But you split? God, how cheap is that? You know what I mean? It's, wait, isn't it a little bit? It's like, let me get a ride with you. And you're like, well, you know, get a ride with me. But, like, you can pull out your phone, too, and tap it together and, like, split in an algorithmic form. I don't know. Just let me get a ride with you, right? Can somebody just give each other a ride one of these days? That might have been a metaphor. If it was, I didn't get it. We have a very special guest in the house who I'd like to welcome to the stage now. Marcelo Hernandez Castillo. Let me say a few things about this exceptional gentleman. He is from Zacatecas in Mexico. He crossed over the border with his family illegally at age 5. I say this because he says this in his bio, and I think this is a fucking important thing to note, which is that language, literature, poetry, love do not have borders. So it doesn't fucking matter where anybody came from or how they're here, as long as they are respected for the quality and of their verse and what they're saying. But he has done so much, I believe, to help people who are undocumented in this country share their work. And one of the things he's done is he worked with Undocupoets, which is, yeah, sorry, Marcelo. Undocupoets successfully helped to remove citizenship requirements from a lot of the poetry book prizes, poetry book prizes all around the country. So for all you poets in the house, one of the great ways to become a authorized poet is to submit your manuscript to a poetry prize, where you send in your manuscript, they read through hundreds, they pick it, they publish it, all of a sudden you're a published authorized poet. So what Undocupoets did is it removed the citizenship requirement so that anybody, regardless of how they're in this country, can be authorized by this country as a poet. He is also the first undocumented poet to get an MFA from Michigan. And we are honored to have him in the house. So can we please give a big round of applause to Marcelo?
Thank you, Nikhil. Undocumented, not illegal. Antonia Hernandez Castillo. Castillo. Antonia Hernandez Castillo. Thank you, guys. That's my mother. She's not here today. El frutero. My father likes his fruit sweeter than his women, a little bruised. I imagine he is growing a garden in his room next to mine. I imagine he holds my mother's face and slowly parts its earth for a plum orchard. In the morning, I know I'm supposed to look away from his reaping. My mother's face, a blue, unknown in seeds, her ringed and limp body flapping with air. It is early. She smiles at me, and I don't look away. Her eyelids opening long enough for me to see the ripeness his hands are capable of tying in a knot. I will gently gather her eyes and tuck them in my pocket and put her to sleep and bury them somewhere far so she will never find them. I will rub salt all over her body so nothing will grow there again. Gesture with both hands tied. I'm going to open the borders of my hunger and call it a parade. But I'm lying if I said I was hungry. If dying required practice, I could give up the conditions for being alone. Why is it always noon in my head? I'm going to run outside and whisper, or hold a gun and say bang. Or hold a gun and not do anything. All the lamps that wait inside me saying, come. The gift is the practice. The rope is the door. Sugar. Dulce. My father's hands split peaches in half and fed me. That was my mouth and that was his nail. Salt and a little piss. Always parallel to the leather, to my ass bleeding with welts, to my ass purple with love, and to the belt he called Daisy. And I said, hello, Daisy. And she said, hello. And he bent over the sink with a bowl in his face, and he, the only tunnel of song for miles in any direction. The white switch that will not speak, and he a man once again after it's all over. My father's hands will love a man at the first sign of weakness. Their suffering was our suffering. Thick cords dipped in water. They peeled the skin off a calf still breathing. They were two doves courting the calf, who was also a dove in its thrashing, then warm, then still. They cut through the air like ghosts. They were large and capable of great things. I always came when they called. They always had peaches to put in my mouth. Wetback. When the first boy called me a wetback, I filled his mouth with the bees that have died in my house. How good it must have felt before the small village echoed its grief in his throat, before the sirens began ringing. And we were on stage, which meant it was a show, which meant our only definition of a flower was also a flower. I waved like they taught me, like a little miss something. I didn't want to pretend it felt good. I didn't want to keep saying my name into the microphone like a champ. Yes, I could have ripped open his throat. I could have blown him a kiss from the curtain. I wanted to dance by myself in a dark room filled with the wingless bodies of bees. To make of this our own Old Testament with all the same beheaded kings, with all the same beheaded kings pointing at all the same beheaded prophets, the rain and our dresses still on fire. The same unborn Christ running through every door like a man who's left his child in the car. But the lights were too bright. I couldn't hear him because I wasn't on stage. I was lying on the floor of an empty house with old carpet. I could have been anyone's idea of pity. How quiet our prophets. Let my back remind him of every river. I pulled the bees out of his mouth and cupped them in my palm. I told him my Spanish name. There was nothing dry on my body, the lamps falling over in the dark of me. How to grow the brightest geranium. I'm not ashamed, the story goes. I swear I will learn to leave a room without ever touching every part of your face. First gesture in reverse. I'm lying on the floor. I'm on the floor lying on my back in my underwear. Here I spread open and become the knife with its large smile tilting away. This is a star. And this is a star, because I'm thirsty, because there isn't an end. I could be a bride. Here are the lips, and the rain, and the sound they are capable of inside each other. Here the mirror through which I am unbearable. The brown boy waving the flag of his deported father. The brown boy kissing the floor back. If I can still close, I will let the rain finish what the light began and never tell anyone about it. Immigration interview with Don Francisco. In the church was the steepest well of the city where the priest was lowered every moment, every morning. Redacted. If I had two shadows, I would place one in the throats of my children to stop the wasps and their multitude of hands from clapping. Redacted. I've already split open the small fish and counted the candles inside, all the pink nails tapping the wicks. Redacted. If I had children, there would be no reason to empty the bowls. No reason at all to keep saying trigger, as if that alone will break us. Redacted. How small the dolls, how insignificant the hand that moves them. Redacted. Perhaps the butterflies are mute because no one would believe their terrible stories. Redacted. Gesture and pursuit. I want to be the bride days later when she is no longer a bride, combing her hair in the mirror. But it's too late. I've already locked myself in a room and imagined every variation of witness and music. I want everything to touch me before it is bright enough to slip through the house undetected. Like the sound of a child in the womb tending its own window. in which case anything is bright enough. Instead, I will breathe into my hands where my eyes used to be when once I looked outward from inside my mother to the other body pressed against hers. Thanks so much for inviting me here. I really appreciate it. And I'll read my last poem titled Sensontle, which I've thought recently, this is a book of failures. Sensontle. Because the bird flew before there was a word for flight. Years from now, there will be a name for what you and I are doing. I licked the mango of the sun. Between its bone and its name, between its color and its weight, the night was heavier than the light it hushed. Pockets of unsteady light, the bone, the seed inside the bone, the echo and its shape. Can you wash me without my body coming apart in your hands? Call it wound. Call it beginning. The bird's beak twisted into a small circle of awe. You called it cutting apart. I called it song. Thank you.
One more time, please, for Marcelo Hernandez Castillo. Marcelo, how do we find out more about your work? Do you have a website? Do you have any books available? Do you have? Look them up on Google. You heard it here first. That's the way. Can we please have a round of applause for Bowery Duo over here, holding it down? And Keenan over here keeps switching between the sax and the piano. I like this. Never know what to expect there. All right, let's see. I would like to welcome back to the open mic. Can we please give it up for Hannah Wood?
Thank you. Hi, guys. How are you doing? Good? Fantastic. Oh, good. This is not scientifically accurate at all, I think, but it's called Mars. Let's get fucked up on Mars, propel ourselves past the stars, to shove our hands in the red dust. We'll bring our own libations, but leave our earthbound frustrations. We'll start anew with hearts racing and brains euphoric, and find love under multiple moons. Crawling up and rolling down heaping sand dunes, so far away from the debris of orbiting memories. Let's get fucked up on Saturn. I guess we'll make it a pattern. We'll be so trashed by then, we won't even remember how it happened. The way we orbited the Earth and picked a speck in the distance, ripe for debauchery amid isolation. Let's get fucked up on Mercury, the nexus of interplanetary circuitry. And we'll lose some of the others and really become lovers. And it's hot, so hot, we'll never be caught. Isn't that what you want? Let's get fucked up on Uranus. I don't need to explain this. Let's get fucked up on Pluto. To miss it would be brutal. Is it a planet? Is it not? The people who care to judge are millions of light years hence or thence. So let's go there. A bottle of whiskey, a 24-pack of Guinness, nothing but love and trust between us. There's really nothing to fear out in all that vastness of this stratosphere unconquered. Thank you.
Let's give it up one more time for Hannah Wood. All right, everybody, we're going to take a short break, just a couple of minutes, Stretch your legs, refresh your wine, and we will be back with our wonderful feature and a few more open mic poets. Thank you, guys.
Thank you.
Give it up for the Bowery duo, Kenan Jones, Chaser Holmes, playing such sweet, smooth, sexy jazz that you got this couple making out over here. I'm like, feel it in my heart, and I look over and they're doing it. I'm like, yeah, that's happening. That's happening over there. Ow! All right. Other people are feeling it too, I suppose. I would like to welcome the stage on the open mic, Queen! Come on up, Queen! Ow!
Thank you. Hi. I'm gonna roll up my sleeves, you know. You're not ready to roll up your sleeves. You have the power of repression. Suppression of my expressions. I became a target to your aggression. No negation, that was the beginning of my revelation. With so much temptation, I could not meet your expectations. Victimized to your accusations led to continuous frustrations. The irony of your tyranny was, you were no lover to me. I came to the conclusion you are my spiritual enemy. Rebel at heart, I will not succumb to your demands. Understand, I had to take control of the situation at hand. With your inability to compromise, controlling qualities led to my demise. Intangible chains, I could not cut these ties. Confused my pain for weakness, ignored my cries. Speaketh of lies, I see through your disguise. You said, submit my will, I'd rather die. Through you, I experienced true deception. Carefully scripted words to force a connection. Surrounded by your negative perceptions, expecting obedience with no exceptions. Shamelessly slowing my progression, loyalties always questioned. Desperate for false confessions, you became the emblem of my depression. Slave in chains to sacrifice, my dignity had paid the price. Spoke the word of sweet nothings to entice, your reasoning will not suffice. Watch me struggle through all your strife, I'll take back what's left because it's right. No remorse for the way you expertly managed to carefully plant those insecurities to take advantage. I am still here, yet you have done all your damage. These scars are all healed and my sadness has vanished. But you have the power of bondage. Held my heart in thrall and said we were bonded. Master manipulator holding my will hostage. Bounded my whole being, leaving my soul haunted.
One more round of applause for Queen, please. Way to kick us back off with the open mic. I would like to welcome to the stage now Shannon Wenzel. Where are you, Shannon? Come on up, Shannon.
This was written October 5th, so I'll just say it's October 5th. I've always been taught to expect the worst and hope for the best. When I asked to meet you, I did not expect you to respond, but you did. My body was a live wire on the subway. I could not hide my trembling hands. Everything within me shook as my mind played scenarios of you breaking my heart against asphalt, of cold eyes laughing, telling me they are all so much better than you ever could have been. I expected blood. I stopped on the corner and waited for directions, tried to lose myself in the music in my ears, tried to force my heart to harden for the impact. I climbed the stairs and found you crouched in your chair, the same strange, wild man I stumbled upon almost a year ago in the same place at exactly the wrong time. You looked up after a moment, a heartbeat's length of silence before you said, "Hey, there was no blood, there was no breaking. The storm was still for the first time this year. In the back of my mind, I was afraid of the ease that I felt, the way the hour we confined ourselves to slipped away into 3 to 4, laughing as if there was no distance between us, as if I did not spend the last few months waiting to die. As if I did not come here armed with bandages of sutures stitched with verses and choruses to piece myself together again after the departure. Here's the separate secret wars we have been living. I spent 2 years defining and redefining my own existence, opened and bled myself on greyhounds at barricades, while you hunched in libraries and rooms with books and papers, hiding your heart away in beautiful forms, but losing faith in your own words, shutting yourself off to mine for fear of the way they might move you. We stood in the doorway at what I thought was the end, while panic seized my chest as I realized we never spoke of the reasons of why I came, what I reached out to confront, to ask why you stayed silent all year, why you ran weeks ago. But the ease and laughter was answer enough. Here is the purest truth my heart ever conjured. All I ever want to do is laugh with you. There is still life here. I watched your face change with those words, collapse into a mixture of relief and guilt, your body held tightly, visibly relaxed. I guess you expected blood too. But see, this was never a call for grandiose gestures, dramatics, or middle-of-the-rain confessions. I just wanted to be able to call your name and know that you would answer. To meet your eyes in a crowded place and smile, tell stories about travels and memories and plans, making space for you and I within our everyday in-between routines, the honesty of tired bodies curling against each other in the night. Because through all your adventures and all your wandering, your wolfish vagabond heart will always have a safe place to return to. Here, with mine. Somewhere close to dawn, we held each other, our fingers intertwined and my breath caught in my throat. I watched your hands with tears in my eyes and confessed my weaknesses to the walls of your bedroom. Please don't disappear this time. I winced at how small my voice sounded then, tightened my fingers around yours, suddenly afraid, as if you were going to fade in half a minute more, and I needed to remember this feeling. Instead, I felt your deferential heart continue to beat steadily against my back, your breath on my neck, warm as hope, as you whispered, "I won't." October 5th. I wish I knew you lied. Thank you.
One more time, please, for Shannon Wenzel. We're just about finished with our open mic section of this evening. Except we haven't heard anything from our English student contingent. Have you chosen a representative yet? I'm not kidding here, guys. You come all the way here. You're literature students. I want something. It can be a poem. It can be a short story. It can be a joke. It can be a dance. It can be a song. Who's it gonna be? Come on. Yes? We got any brave souls in the house? Would we like our German visitor to choose for us? She's ready to, I can tell. Come on up, somebody. I love it. All right, well, is there anybody in the house who has not gotten a chance to do a poem who would like to do one? And you can take the spot of the shy Britishers in the house tonight. All right, can we please have a round of applause for all the wonderful poets who read on the open mic tonight? Do you guys all have your little tickets that you used to come in here tonight? Now we found out who bought a ticket and who snuck in. If you've got a ticket, you get a vote. Even if you're not a documented citizen, you have a vote in poetry. All right, please. We are going to choose our favorite poet from the open mic. And then we are going to hear our spectacular feature. So I'm gonna do a little recap. When I call your name, poet, stand up, give a little wave. Marion, our wonderful technician, will hit you with the spotlight so we know who you are. We are choosing our favorite poet who read on the open mic. At the end of the season, we're gonna have a showdown of all the winning poets, and the winner is going to have a film of one of their poems produced by our production companies. We're gonna make a poem film with you. So, please choose your favorite poet. In no particular order, Nick! Where are you, Nick? All right. Kayla Martin! Woo! Hobart! Mike Lyles! Hey. Hannah Wood! Queen! Where are you, Queen? Elizabeth! And Shannon Wenzel! All right, so please write down the name of your favorite poet from the open mic. This might be your friend. If it is, you're very lucky because you have a talented friend. I think it's probably someone you've never seen or heard from before. Someone who you just thought was absolutely spectacular and wrote the poem which touched you. So please, please vote with your inner literary critic. Be harsh and choose your favorite poem. We want the finest poet from the night. And please hold up your votes when you've got them so we can collect them. Make sure, hold them up high. And we're gonna grab them all, make sure everyone. Does everybody know what they're doing? Has everyone gotten a chance to vote? If you don't have a pen, you can write in blood. If you don't have a ballot, that means you didn't pay. We are a nonprofit, so screw you. Then again, poets are poor, so good for you. I would say our votes are in. We are going to announce our winner at the end of the night. There is a beautiful book up near Liz Peters over by the door. Can we say hi and give a round of applause for Liz Peters? She curates Poet New York and works for Bowery Poetry, makes this series happen. And tonight we have an exceptional feature who has just released this book last fall called Buzzing Hemisphere, Rumor Hemisferico. And it is put out by the University of Arizona Press. I just want to read one of the many glowing reviews on the back. A stereo ping pong game between two languages. Neither Spanglish nor translations. These poems are unique to the language, related yet original to both. This book is by Urayoán Noel. And Urayoán is from Puerto Rico, now lives in the Bronx, like our friend over here from the Bronx. We only get one hand this time. Make some noise for the Bronx. He is a true New Yorican poet. We are honored to have him. Please welcome to the stage, Urayoán Noel.
Maestro, tengo mi propia batería. Solneto, soneto silábico en escalinata. Sol, crisol, o frijol, grito bemol, perdido en el mall de un downtown sin farol. En la ciudad de aerosol y arterias de colesterol, postales de otra Sebastopol, interceptadas por la metropol, en rascacielos de sangre tornasol, Apollinaire degolló soles en alcohol. Los contraterroristas soplan su caracol. Hologramas digitales de un falso rock and roll. Now, maestro, help me out here, right? Starting off with one and then two and then so on, okay? Sunnet, syllabic staircase sonnet. Sun, one beat. You stun with your gun aimed at no one. Where car tires spun, now street heat comes undone. Like some 70s rerun, burned under the skin just for fun. And the CEO who calls 911, and the corpse with its hair in a bun. No one is an island, but we are all done. While the mall music plays, we've only just begun. As remixed by the ghosts of La Lupe and Big Pun. And counter-terrorist texts, son, the enemy has won. Big hands for the drummer. Thank you to the wonderful house band. Give a big hand. Thank you to Nikhil. Yeah. Thank you to Liz. Thank you to Bowery Poetry. This book, as you see, involves a lot of walking around, right? The flannery, urban flannery, but in the age of the smartphone. So for this next piece actually emerges from walking out of this neighborhood, through this neighborhood that used to be called Loisaida. Anybody? The New Yorican Lower East Side, Loisaida in Spanglish, right? After the great poet Bimbo Rivas. But then real estate interests decided, well, that sounds too ethnic. Let's call it Alphabet City. From Avenue A to Avenue D, so see, it's the alphabet. I couldn't deal with it. I couldn't deal with the mistranslation, the imperial translation of Loisaida into Alphabet City. So I wrote these alphabet poems. Take this, Alphabet City. And to know this, you have to know the difference between the alphabet in English and Spanish. Everybody know what it is? Yeah. What's the difference? And so I do this with the band. There's no band tonight except the band inside. So the contraband. Acompáñame, bucéfalos come libros. Definitivamente estoy febril. Grandes hallazgos intuyo jadeando. Kantianos, lameculos, malaya. Noticieros, ñapa obligatoria. Parecemos quimeras repitiendo secuestros. Tecnócratas urbanos visitando Wikipedia. Cenófobos youtubeando zozobras. Accomplished bookworms can definitely entertain feverish grandeurs huddled in jizz-stained knowledge labs. Many news orphans prefer quizzing radically sectarian technocrats. Utterance vacancy workshops. Xeroxed, YouTubed, zip-drived. Aquí bebemos cerveza de Sabrina. Esperamos familia. Gozamos hasta inmolarnos juntos. Karaoke lengua sucio. Masticando nuestro ñame o panapén. Qué rico sabe. Tragamos un viejo Whitman xilográfico. Yace. Zarrapastroso. It's like star twinkling, twinkling star, but with Spanish alphabet. Our beer cans disposable. Every family grows, hating itself. Joint karaoke lives, mouthing nothing. Our preference, queer regret, silent turmoil, undressing, viewing Whitman's X film, yielding zilch. Anunciaban bandas, conciertos, desiertos, estadios falsos, gran hazaña imposible, jodido karma, lóbrega mañana. Nosotros, ñoños, o peor, quitados, rindiéndonos súbitamente, tontos, utópicos, velando valquirias, xilófonos y zampoñas. Absent bands, concerts, deserted, empty fields, go, human, impossible, jaded karma, lousy morning, noticing ourselves, provisionally, quitter's revolution, sorta, tongue-tied, utopian, Valkyrie watchers, xylophones, yowling, scythers, y aquí se acaba la canción del alfabeto, pero ahora el poeta improvisa, no tengo visa, todos somos undocu-queer, o todos somos lo que queremos ser. Y no paro de improvisar. Are you uncomfortable yet? You wanted open mic. You wanted New York downtown, experimental, far out, punk, crazy, hip hop, improvisation. Guess what? That nation's dead. Eso no existe ya. We're gentrified. We're owned by global corporate banks, so no thanks, but we're not here to be cool or to be edgy. We're here to support global banking. We're here to support the status quo. We're here to be hegemonic and maybe get paid, at least if you buy some books. Compren, compren, no sean cabrones, para que la poesía sobreviva. And I'm running out of rhymes. Call them rimas que se aproximan. We're improvisation nation. That means we're all undocu-queer. That means there are no fronteras. Stop fronting for this era. Stop fronting for any era. La era era. Ahora lo que es lo que fue, lo que seremos. Lo que nunca fuimos. Funciones de smartphone. Naciones o aplicaciones? As in web aplicaciones, sin explicaciones. Cabrones. Okay, so, that was kind of potty mouth. Sorry, Bowery. So let's do two more. I'm in the translation vibe, so I'll do this as a shout out to Marcelo, who's a friend, Canto Mundo fellow, Canto Mundo in the house, great Latino poets organization. We're both fellows, so love to our Canto Mundo familia, but also a translator. So this is my attempt at a translation and to do some Boricua, right? Boricua Mexicano, right? Fronterizo love. This is my attempt at a tribute to one of our untranslatable poets, and I've been doing this for a few years now. Reading Spanish language poetry into my smartphone with voice recognition set to English and generating homophonic mistranslations to show that Spanish language poets cannot be Google translated. And so today's poet is the great Sor Juana Inés de la Cruz, the great poet of the Mexican and Latin American Baroque. This is a 17th century sonnet. I won't tell you the original by the book title, but I will read a line from the original, followed by the homophonic translation that the smartphone helped me generate. Y dice así, you have the nice weather, after a sonnet by Sor Juana Inés de la Cruz. En perseguirme, mundo, ¿qué interesas? In Tennessee, You phone book. You use me. Sucks. ¿En qué te ofendo cuando solo intento? In get still friends, one before leaving, bro. Poner bellezas en mi entendimiento. For me an ass off, send me and send the info. Y no mi entendimiento en las bellezas. You know me, and in the me, Las Vegas, us. Yo no estimo tesoros ni riquezas. Doing with the mall, the sodas, progress sucks. Y así siempre me causa más contento. Yeah, CC, on the outside, Moscone Center. Poner riquezas en mi entendimiento. When you get up, do you do me? And que no mi entendimiento en las riquezas. So you know an inconvenience, ass kicker sucks. Y no estimo hermosura que vencida. Email to the animal, so Karen, see there. En despojo civil de las edades. This will see you, benefit added. Ni riqueza me agrada fementida. Do you think it's a matter of cream and be there? Temiendo por mejor en mis verdades. Any and go for me tomorrow. Read about this. Consumir vanidades de la vida. Cancel me? Too funny. I'm gonna be there. Que consumir la vida en vanidades. Get on some you. I love you there in bunny rabbits. Sor Juana Inés de la Cruz, mistranslated by my phone. Que viva Sor Juana. And I'll close with this. This is a book inspired by traversing hemispheres. So these are brain hemispheres, but also world hemispheres. So this last piece was inspired by bus rides from New York, from New York City to upstate, and from Rio de Janeiro to Sao Paulo, Brazil. So there was a lot of noise I can't reproduce because buses are noisy. But again, I'll use the phone to create some ambient. And maestro, feel free to jump in, band, if you want to do your thing. Letreros del hemisferio, signs of the hemisphere. Mine's the hum of hemisphere, the silence of its midnight boulevards, from the Bronx's Grand Concourse to 9 de Julio in Buenos Aires, but not the paramodern city aping Paris, a modernity of imitation onto parody, and imported Pierrots, and not quite the boulevards of revolution, of blow darts aimed at the pates of robber barons. Instead, mine is the hum of Césaire's archipelagos, and Damas's tam-tams, and Aroldo's galaxies, and Vallejo's archipelagos, and Neruda's elements, and Bishop's loping song, and William's blinding island sky, and William's blinding island sky, and Martí's angst, and Whitman's wonder, and Paz's mire, and Tuzantari's vertigo, and Sor Juana's blaze, and the drum's cry, and the Cree, and the Creoles, claiming no decree, but in deictics, all pointing the way, this way, to the Americas by night, its smiling villages and radiant exurbs, for once at once awake, startled by the hum. Noche in this noche. Avoid evita, evita a evita. No motorcycle in these diaries. Don't bother guessing this loco's motive, this loca's stride. The globe's refraction in drive-through windows. Workers of the world, take off your paper hats. Avoid the avalanche of billboards. Own your memory of ocean and of mountain, the likable catastrophe of your dark eyes, the strophes and stanzas of your struggle that shames the wind chimes tired of hanging. Yours is the hum of becoming. Refuse the fuselage on fire, the carrion's carrion, the staging devices and gaming devices. Recover the signal in mute emission, the knottedness of people, no longer pandering to etas. Your hum, defying the small America, its Anglo angles, and all its inexecutable orders. Even without attributes, we are still tribulators, our fate always in play, our bodies bound by the spray of bullets and ocean, migrants with no return policy, always crossing a bridge without a causeway, corrupting the program, spiking the punch bowl so it leaks again, this time for good, until the punch cards are full of dances. A neural mass no longer misfiring, wide-eyed in wartime cities. Seen through your eyes, I see at last the outlines of a hemisphere. I find my hum in harmony with you, that is, in dissonance with self, in shared discord, in a storm front shared. And so I name my condition of islandness, the tropics of trauma that birthed me, my body damaged and unmanaged, identity in biorhythm, labor of movement in unusual time signatures. Sing, timeless, tuneless, melodia tribe, aimless in meander, out to the jetty, beyond the observation deck, beyond the tourists in knee-high gray gym socks, congregating outside gated communities to take digital footage of the wreckage they can't see. They cannot hear the hum over their headphones, the hum of trade winds on blood-warm seas, the hum that hides in our black sand, in our brown skin, and our purple sky. The rattle of bones after the jackhammers. I hear it, the hum of last resort, the architecture of our capitals, the buzz of our occipitals. The sad beauty of this claptrap synapse. Who hears what I'm reciting? Here's what I'm reciting. The echo and the waves crest. I leave the rest to resigning politicians and the bankers who are gasping for heirs. And so I leave the word in hopeful ruin. I transcribe our reunion. With your help, I begin to transcribe. I transcrub, I transcrawl, I transcry, while holding down over the missing tongue. With your help, I begin. I'm reciting the cyst, I'm resisting the sigh, I'm restoring the song. With your help, I'm resetting the sky. Y pues le cedo mi palabra a la ruina alentadora y transcribo nuestra reunión. Con tu ayuda comienzo a transgrabar, a transtrepar, a transclamar, pisando tierra sobre la lengua ausente. Con tu ayuda empiezo a recitar el tropiezo, a resistir el duelo, a restaurar el canto. Con tu ayuda voy a reiniciar el cielo. Y como todos los poemas, se acaba improvisando y maestro, nos podemos ir al jazz, al free jazz sabroso. Si usted quiere darle un poquito de swing para la gente del Bowery, mis bonds a mí del Bowery, venga maestro, con la batería, there you go. Just pretend you saw a decent rock band, though you didn't. Just pretend we're all salsa conjunto that has the ritmo. Even though my flow is so-so, it's what you get for poetry. I can't really sing, but I call it performance art. And I make it take place downtown, and it seems edgy. It seems subversive. It means immersive. It seems participatory. There's no participation in Application Nation. We are all split-screened, YouTube zip-cribed, as I mentioned. Evidentiary hearings is all we do. One smartphone at a time. These things, how much do they go for a month? How much is your data plan? And it can't even play the harmonica. I guess maybe it can. What kind of blues can you do with this? Except the data mining blues, except being owned by Google and being the digital poodle of the cosmic kennel of Information Nation. Improvisation is a failing, but it's a buzz. That buzz is a hemisphere. That buzz is the America. That buzz could also be that bus I have to catch to get home back to the Bronx. There's no express. Yo me expreso como puedo en inglés o en español, pero no hay voz para el Bronx. No tengo voz. No puedo hablar. ¿Y vos? ¿Tenés voz? ¿Tenés voz? It's all just buzz. It's all just so much noise. The yo is noise. The tú is noise. The voz is busted. The voz is busted. The voz is imposter voz. Impossible boss. Only buzz, only blues, Improvisation Nation ends here in an open mic. Openness is what neoliberal systems want. Define yourself through open markets. Nothing remarkable about that. Nothing about my flow that makes you go, whoa, that dude sure does know his poesia. Don't wanna be ya, well fine, don't be me. Let me go home. Just tell your friends to buy some books. Urayoán Noel.com, please. Make me into a meme. Make me go viral. Poetry doesn't matter, but with your help, we can shatter all media records and maybe have our MC get paid tonight. That's what we are. We're shards of former selves and communities. But you know what? There's beauty in we. Y le llamo poesía. Pues sí. Bowery, poe, free. Gracias.
Can we give these two gentlemen a big round of applause? And can you guys help me announce the winner tonight?
Let's do it, yeah.
Can you get your instrument out and jam along with the band? Kick something up. We need a.
Sorry, I need a drink before that.
Third base?
Before I get my instrument.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, I understand. I see how it is. Buy his book, get him a free drink, that sort of thing. Is Ashley August in the house? Oh! Up next after this show at 9 p.m. is. That's Ashley August, host of Bowery Slam, coming up next at 9 p.m. Do we have a winner for tonight? Can you guys bring us up a little slip? Can you give Marcelo the winner? Let's give it up one more time, please, for the Bowery Duo. Thanks to Frances over at the bar. Don't forget to tip her. Woo! This is the 110th Poet in New York. We are here every Monday at 6:30 p.m. and streaming live on the YouTube. If you go search Bowery Poetry on YouTube, we got a channel. We got an Instagram. We got a Facebook. We got all that stuff. And we got some poesia. Marcelo, would you please announce the winner tonight?
The winner is Nick.
Do you have anything to say for yourself other than a curse? Hold on, stay on up, stay up. We gotta get a group photo. Congratulations to Nick. Nick, Bowery is buying you a copy of RUN's book. Hold on, Nick. You're trying to escape here. You're going to get that signed by Urayoán before you go. It's a gift. Thank you guys all for coming to tonight's show. I'm Nikhil Melnechuk, your host. We're here every Monday at 9:30. At, no, 6:30. Bowery Slam is up next at 9. How's the Bronx doing? Drinking. He's happy. Have a great night. Thank you, guys.